There was a time when blacks could only perform in certain areas for blacks. The Royal Peacock was part of the Chitlin Circuit, so if an artist come to town, they would perform at the Fox for the white people, and they'll perform at the Royal Peacock for the blacks.
Originally opened in the 1930s as the Top Hat, the Royal Peacock was one of the most popular African-American-owned blues and R&B nightclubs in Atlanta for decades, visited by many celebrities and famous musicians.
This particular building is a very famous building because Martin Luther King partied in this building. Malcolm X has been in this building. I mean, you name the famous jazz musician, they have been to this building. This was literally the Cotton Club of the South.
You have Al Green, to name one, Sam Cooke, to name another, Aretha Franklin, the big time football and baseball stars of the time would come to the Peacock as a hangout spot. It was a very well-known hangout spot in the 70s and in the 60s. The Peacock definitely represents the last standing like beacon of light from a time when people was trying to make a stand against the racism in America. We owe it to Atlanta to keep it open, functional, and operating.
At its prime, Auburn Avenue was one of the richest black neighborhoods in the world. Although many of the old businesses and buildings have been shut down or abandoned, the Royal Peacock still stands strong as an icon for Atlanta's music and nightlife.
It's been blessed. It's surprisingly it hasn't got hit by a wrecking ball, you know, because so many things in this area have gone the way of the dodo, just extinct. You don't know it ever existed. You don't know what caused the demise. Obviously, the person who built it must have did something good, because the floor is still strong. People are stomping on the floor every night, so and it survives. You know, they don't just dance, they stomp on it.